Hi, I'm Katie from Notbook, and we're here with Paul from Empire. So, Paul, what is planned or upcoming for the next Empire Cup event?
Well, interesting question that, because of course, most of the time we have no idea what's planned, because of course it's a very PvP game, very player versus player. So obviously, although we know that everyone's going to be in their nations and so on, what actually is going to occur is pretty much in the realm of the players rather than us as crew.
Yeah, that's true.
I mean, yeah, we've got plots.
Yeah.
But obviously, I couldn't talk about what plots we've got lined up. And quite frankly, the classic thing is, of course, no plot survives hitting the players anyway, because you never know what they're going to do.
that is true. Yeah.
I'm sure there'll probably be some battles
that
are going to occur. They're probably going to involve some orc tribes. But again, that pretty much depends on what the generals in the military council decide to do. It's a good question.
Yeah, definitely. As far as nations go,
yep.
Is there any particular nation that's been doing more than others?
You're not really asking the right person, really, because of the kind of roles that I do in Empire, I don't actually really know what politics each nation gets up to. You know, I'm part of the civil service, so I'm kind of like, I'm part of the cogs that help the Empire, and help the heroes of the Empire, which obviously the players. Get on and do their thing. So, you know, I see the Empress and she's around, and the Senate, and they're busy making lots of political decisions in the Senate. I know there is a lot of problems with fighting on too many battle fronts at the moment, and effectively I think they're bankrupting the Empire unless they do something about it. But that's entirely up to the players and the senators and the generals to make the decisions as to what to do about that. But it's one of the things I really like about the game is we have a really good working economy, and that the players really have to make, effectively, and ironically to say, they have to make profound decisions on what to do, and that's the classic thing. So, but in actual fact, which particular nations, I don't really know, to be fair.
That's fair.
Sorry.
It's okay. Do you enjoy being a civil servant?
Oh, I love it. I think it's really great. You know, I do kit fairs because I want to encourage new players into our hobby. I think we've got a really great game. And I think being a civil servant is kind of, it's really good at like helping people out, because that's effectively all I'm doing, is that like we have this thing called the hub, which is kind of where we all live, and we all got specialties as well. So obviously my specialty is I deal with imperial elections, and unfortunately the Senate keeps on making more imperial positions, and as they make more imperial positions, more people have to be put in, more citizens have to be voted into those positions in whatever manner that has been chosen. So there's more elections for me to have to deal with, so I'm kind of running around quite a lot trying to get those sorted. But yes, it's really fun, and it's really rewarding, and it's really good seeing new people come into the hobby and helping them enjoy themselves, which is what we try and do in the civil service, and the new player team, which is the team of staff who are kind of involved with players new to Empire and new to the hobby of live role-playing.
Well, thank you very much. That'll be us for now. We'll see you again in a minute.